Today, I'm going to answer the question, what are the best pre-med majors to prepare for medical school? The competition to get into medical school is notoriously high. If you're like many pre-med students, you'll take any way to increase your admissions odds. You already know in order to be a competitive applicant, you have to earn a strong GPA, get a high MCAT score, and acquire relevant research experience. But how will your pre-med major affect your chances of getting into medical school? If you ask around, you might hear some answers based on misconceptions and rumors. Maybe you've been told you have to be a biology major, or you might have heard that English majors have the best medical school acceptance rates. What should you believe? I'm Dr. Pranjal Gupta, medical school admissions expert from Shemassian Academic Consulting. In this video, I'll go over med school acceptance rates by major to explain which majors have the greatest success and why, so you know what the best pre-med major is for you and how to maximize your admissions odds. Let's get started. According to the AAMC, there are a few pre-med majors that have higher med school acceptance rates than others. In 2019-2020, the three groups of majors with the highest acceptance rates were physical sciences with 48%, math and statistics with 47%, and humanities with 46%. Biological science majors, which included over half of med school applicants, had an acceptance rate of 41%, followed closely by social science majors with a 40% acceptance rate. Before we move on, let's define the different major groups that I just listed. The physical sciences group includes chemistry, physics, earth sciences, and astronomy majors. The math and statistics group is straightforward. The humanities group is broad but covers majors like English, philosophy, history, and foreign languages. The biological sciences group includes different focuses of biology, like microbiology, neurobiology, and even zoology. Lastly, the social sciences group includes psychology, sociology, political science, and economics. Now they're on the same page, let's get back to the data. At first glance, you might be tempted to switch your pre-med major to physics or philosophy, but looking only at the acceptance rate by major won't give you the whole picture or point out the actual best pre-med major for you. Let's go over GPA and MCAT score by major, since these are the two biggest factors used by ADCOMS to evaluate applications. For both physical science and math and statistics major applicants, the average science GPA was 3.56. Humanities majors had an average 3.44 science GPA, and for bioscience majors, it was 3.49. Social science applicants had an average 3.38 science GPA. It's important to note that science GPA isn't a perfect correlation with acceptance rates by pre-med major. Physical science and math and statistics majors have the highest GPAs, so their high acceptance rates make sense, but the average humanities science GPA is lower than the average biological sciences GPA. You must be wondering, how could humanities majors have a higher acceptance rate with a lower science GPA? Science majors can get quite indignant about the subject, but let's not get ahead of ourselves. We've only looked at the average science GPA. Medical schools consider cumulative GPA as well, so let's review those numbers next. Again, physical sciences and math and statistics majors tie with the average highest cumulative GPA of 3.61. Humanities applicants had an average 3.58 cumulative GPA. For biological science majors, the average cumulative GPA was 3.59, and for social science majors, it was 3.52. We see the GPA gap between humanities and bioscience majors getting smaller here. So even with a lower science GPA, humanities majors are able to earn high grades in their major coursework to make up for to make their cumulative GPA competitive with science majors. Now you might be understanding the chip on the shoulders of many science majors. It doesn't seem fair that they follow a more challenging course of study, perform slightly above humanities majors, but still get accepted at a lower rate. But before we agree that their complaint is justified, we need to look at MCAT scores by major. The highest applicant MCAT scores belong to math and statistics majors. Next were physical science and humanities majors, followed by biological science and social science majors. So this is the area where we see the humanities majors have an edge over the bioscience majors. And maybe that surprises you. Shouldn't biological science majors do the best on the MCAT? After all, half of the test is focused on science. Hold that thought, because we'll talk about the MCAT in detail a little bit later. Does the data point to a specific pre-med major that makes it easier to get into medical school? Well, the numbers show us that high MCAT scores and GPA are the most predictive factors of med school acceptance. The two majors with the highest acceptance rates, physical sciences and math and statistics, both had the best average GPA and MCAT scores. And even though humanities majors had a lower average science GPA than biological majors did, they scored on average 2 points higher on the MCAT. So setting aside the influence of GPA and MCAT scores, no pre-med major by itself can guarantee your acceptance to medical school. I mean, certainly ADCOMs aren't accepting English majors with a 3.2 GPA and 500 MCAT scores solely because they study humanities. And conversely, bio majors with similar stats will be met with the same decision. Med schools are quite clear about not requiring or preferring certain pre-med majors from their applicants. Most programs purposefully cultivate a diverse mix of majors in their incoming classes. For example, Harvard Medical School states they prefer applicants with well-balanced academic backgrounds, especially exposure to humanities and social sciences. This doesn't mean science majors are at a disadvantage when applying to medical schools. However, 70% of Harvard Med School's incoming class in 2019 were science majors. This shows it's possible to achieve the desired academic balance through minors or elective courses. So what we've learned is that there isn't one best pre-med major for everyone, but there are majors that might make it easier to earn a high GPA, receive a strong MCAT score, or showcase a well-balanced academic background. Many students believe that pre-meds have to major in biology or another science. After all, the required major coursework overlaps closely with medical school prereqs, making it easy to build a comfortable class schedule. In addition, science majors have close access to research opportunities within their academic departments. But remember, biological sciences majors didn't perform better on the MCAT. While the MCAT does assess scientific knowledge, it also evaluates problem-solving skills, critical thinking, and understanding of social science concepts. The applicants that perform best in the critical analysis and reasoning skills section of the MCAT are math and statistics majors and humanities majors. This is because students in those fields are trained in that kind of critical thinking that helps them be successful on the MCAT. And don't forget, they've taken the same pre-med prereqs as everyone else. So they have the necessary science knowledge to be successful on the scientific sections of the MCAT too. But on the other hand, there seems to be a critical thinking skill gap in the required bioscience major coursework, leaving bio majors with lower scores in humanities and math and statistics majors. But don't be discouraged if you want to major in one of the biological sciences. You can take the initiative to pursue your own opportunities to develop critical thinking skills and boost your score in this section of the MCAT. All right, let's get back to finding which pre-med major is best for you. In light of all the data and the major insights, how should you go about choosing the best pre-med major for you? Above all, prioritize the requirements needed to get into medical school. You have to succeed in the pre-med school prereqs. This includes biology, gen chem, organic chemistry, biochem, physics, stats, calculus, and English, plus a few courses in arts, humanities, and social sciences. That's a lot of classes to complete, so make sure they fit alongside the major that you choose. You might need to take summer classes if your pre-med major doesn't overlap with these prereqs. As you've seen in all the data, you need a high MCAT score to increase your med school admissions odds. Prepping and studying for the MCAT requires a lot of time, so make sure your major coursework won't be too intense in the months leading up to when you take the MCAT. Research experience is an unspoken requirement because med schools want to graduate doctors who can engage with scientific literature and possibly publish their own groundbreaking research. It makes the med schools they went to look good. You can acquire research experience if you're not a science major, but you might have to advocate a little harder for yourself to secure a coveted research assistant position when competing with science majors who might be able to lean on their connections in the science departments. And don't forget the letters of recommendation required for your med school applications, including one from a science professor. If you're a science major, you might take multiple science classes from the same professor, giving them ample material to write a strong recommendation letter. If you choose a non-science pre-med major, you'll need to be persistent in getting to know your science professors and making a strong impression. Obtaining great letters of rec stresses out many med school applicants, but it doesn't need to. Check out our definitive guide for getting the best letters of recommendation. Link is in the description box below. Reviewing these med school application requirements, it's easy to understand why half of all med school applicants choose to major in biological sciences. Applying to medical school as a non-science pre-med major requires additional legwork and initiative, so if you want to go that route, make sure you're up for the challenge. However, for biological science majors, the prereqs research opportunities, and relationships with the science professors you need for your med school applications are more accessible. There's less risk of missing an important med school requirement. You'll just take additional challenging science classes along the way. But many students prefer choosing this well-traveled path, especially if they have a strong aptitude in the sciences. The truth is, the best pre-med major for you is one that highly interests you. Don't choose a major because you think it's the right one or the safe one. If you spend 4 years in classes you find unmotivating and unengaging, your grades will suffer. Instead, select a major that both excites you and challenges you, and you will be naturally driven to do well. On the other hand, don't pick a harder pre-med major only because it will look good on your applications. Adcoms won't cut you any slack for having a low GPA, regardless of how tough your major is. So even though math and statistics majors have one of the highest acceptance rates, if you find that field difficult or uninspiring, you'll likely struggle and hurt your admissions odds if you choose it. If science is your interest, that's great. Major in biological or physical sciences. Those are the best pre-med majors for you. Remember to add a non-science minor or take non-science electives to give you academic balance and develop your critical thinking abilities. If you're passionate about philosophy or literature or psychology, go ahead and choose that as your pre-med major. As long as you fulfill med school requirements and earn high stats, you'll be a highly competitive medical school applicant. In summary, medical schools aren't looking for a specific major. They're looking for high achieving, academically balanced students with developed interests and self-awareness. So when you choose your pre-med major, the best way to increase your admissions odds is to balance meeting your med school requirements with pursuing your genuine interests and passions. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up and subscribe so you don't miss out on new videos. If you'd like to learn more about the medical school admissions process, check out our comprehensive guide below. While you may be a year or two out from applying to medical school, now's the time to start planning and preparing. The strategies in this guide are the same ones our team uses to routinely help students get into schools like Johns Hopkins, Harvard, and UCSF. All right, thanks again for watching. See you next time.